Hello there. Sorry, I wasn't quite expecting you, but since you're here anyway, do you want to talk about the microphone I'm wearing? I kind of want to review it. So this is the Rode Wireless Go. So you know what? Let's just talk about it. Okay, guys. So I'm very sorry for this horrible intro. I know it's been overdone like millions of times, but I've seen YouTubers do this for like 10 to 15 years or something. And I just bought a microphone like this. And I just feel like my first video wearing this has to have a cringy as fuck intro. My apologies, really, I'm really sorry. Please, please stay for the video. I promise the rest will be better. Please, please, please. Well, hello everybody, my name is EK. You are watching EK Tech, obviously. And today, as I mentioned in my horribly cringy intro, we will be talking about the Rode Wireless Go. Now, the Rode Wireless Go, as the name suggests, is a wireless microphone that is on my chest as we speak. It's right here. I can tap it a couple of times. You will hear some nasty, bumpy sounds, but that just shows that I'm recording it through this microphone and not some other thing like some people might have you believe. Okay, so this is going to be a bit of a rambly video because I kind of like to do these videos where I just talk for like 15 or 20 minutes or something, so you guys can have a proper idea of what it sounds like, and you guys can have a proper idea of what I feel about it and how I set it up and everything surrounding that. By the way, guys, I think I might go blind during this video. This is the second time I'm recording this because the first time I didn't quite have the microphone connected. I'm a bit of an idiot. So that means that I'm gonna have to do this again. And I have been staring at the flashlight of my phone, which is giving me proper lighting because I don't have proper lighting set up right now. And it's just making me blind. So if I go blind after today, guys, it's a sacrifice I'm willing to make. It's for this one video, so give me a like because I'm going blind. So guys, talking about the microphone and what it comes in. So first of all, this is a bit of a pouch. It's reasonably tightly secured with this thing. It's reasonably solid, which is very nice because if you're traveling with this thing, you don't want this thing to accidentally open and stuff falling out and stuff. It's made to be a protective case. Let me just show it up a bit closer. So you guys can probably see it right now. I'm not quite sure where the framing is, but it should be somewhere in the middle, I suppose. You can open it up. It's got a reasonably soft inside, but of course it's not like it's cloth because cloth will, you know, break pretty easily. This is pretty soft, it's pretty nice, and it's just really nice and comfortable. It's small, it's easy to travel with. I've actually had this in my pocket for a while when I was out buying some stuff, and it's a pretty good thing. So moving on, we have something that I find to be very cool. So first of all, this cable. Now you might be asking, hey, why the fuck is a cable spectacular? Why do you like a cable? Doesn't everyone have a cable? Well, first of all, it has this nice Rode thing on it. That's amazing, isn't it? Don't you just love it when the brand name is on the thingy? The thingy of which I don't know the name, because I'm honestly not sure what the English name for this is. Anyway, the real cool thing is a lot of technology that you buy, you get one charging cable and you can have like three separate objects that you have to charge, but you only get one charging cable because they're like, you know what? He can get more stuff later. He can buy more stuff from us. Well, Rode has been smart and Rode has provided me with two of these cables. One of the cables is in my PC right now because I had to charge it because they weren't fully charged. But, you know, it's very nice to have these cables because you can just charge both the transmitter on my shirt and the receiver that's on my phone. I'm recording through the Huawei P10 Plus, by the way, more on that later. You charge both of them at the same time, so you don't have a lot of downtime if you're recording longer sessions. Now, another thing that is in the package are these two things. I think they're called wind muffs. They are just there to block wind from coming onto the microphone. So indoors, of course, you don't need these because there's no wind here. But if I were to go outside into an area where it's very windy, like an open area where there's not a lot of walls and stuff to, you know, block the wind from me, and let's say I have to record with something in my back because something behind me is happening. Behind me is a friggin' fire. Look at it, guys, it's a friggin' fire. If I had any editing skills, I would probably put like a fire in the background, but I don't think I will have the skills for that. But let's say I have to record towards the back and from the front there's a lot of wind coming, you know, it's blowing the fire away, and I don't know what I'm talking about, honestly. But let's say I'm in a situation like that and I need to block my microphone from the wind because, I mean, if there's a lot of wind coming onto it, you're gonna hear the annoying blowing wind sound in the microphone, and everyone knows how that sounds because everyone has played a game with a 12-year-old blowing into his headset microphone. Yeah, unfortunately. So these two, you can just attach them to the transmitter. There is of course a built-in microphone here, as you may have noticed, because generally these things require you to have a, you know, a separate lapel mic, you know, one of those tiny mics that you can put on your shirt, and they will then send it through a cable to your transmitter, which is usually located somewhere on like your, I don't really can see it, but like on your belt or on your pocket or something, and then that will of course be sent towards the receiver. Now this one is a bit special because this one has a built-in microphone, which means it just directly takes the audio from here. There's a microphone built in here. I can show it to you guys, 1 second, if I can properly take it off. Now, but without blinding myself, I'm hoping it's fully in frame. Right there, you can see there is a microphone. There is, if I tap on it, probably a bit of an annoying sound. If I were to blow on it, by the way, just to make my point clear, that's not very pleasant. And of course, here there is also, why is my fingernail so long? I should really cut my fingernails, wow. Here is also a microphone port. So if you are to be using a different microphone, let's say you have a separate microphone, you can just still put this one in your pocket or wherever you want to put this one, and of course just have a separate microphone on your shirt. You can even connect this to other audio software, as long as it's a microphone with a 3.5 millimeter port, you can connect it to it and then have it wirelessly be transmitted to the receiver. So it's very nice. Okay, so before talking a bit more about the microphone and microphone position and such, let's quickly talk about the room. And why am I saying this? Well, it's because a lot of YouTubers who are reviewing microphones, they have these amazingly set up rooms where everything is very nice and everything is acoustically treated. They have padding everywhere, and they just make sure that there's nothing wrong with their room to get the best possible sound, so that the sponsors are freaking happy because they get to sell more products because the product seems as good as it can be. Now, is there anything wrong with that? Well, not necessarily. It's good for them, it's good for the company, and it gets more people to buy the product. But one thing that I don't really enjoy about it is the fact that they kind of skew your purchase. Because let's say I buy this one, and I did that, I did buy it because other people were recommending this one because it sounded friggin' amazing. And then you set it up and you're in this room. For example, I'm in my living room right now. It's very echoey, there's a lot of, you know, pretty solid walls. There's not really any reflective material that really prevents the sound from not bouncing around. So the sound is just bouncing all over the place. You can probably hear quite the echo here. So this is a standard situation where you would be if you were like me, you know, a beginning YouTuber or someone else who doesn't have a properly treated room for the best possible sound. So that's also why I'm recording it here. First of all, it's of course because it's the only place where I have friggin' room where I can do some weird dances. I'm honestly not sure what I'm doing. But second of all, it's of course because I want to give you guys a real world example instead of showing you guys what it could be if you had the best possible room. All right, so moving on, let's talk about the microphone position, because a lot of people are saying, and I kind of inclined to agree with that, that you have to put this above the nipple line. Now the nipple line, it's one YouTuber that said it, but I kind of like it, so I'm gonna steal it from that YouTuber. I can't remember his name, but if I do remember, I'll put it in the screen or something. Anyway, the nipple line is from your nipple to your nipple, draw a line above that. That's just, you know, that's the nipple line. It has to be above the nipple line. Now it also has to be below your chin. Now I don't have a funny word for your chin. Maybe it could be like your beard line or something. Maybe is that good? Guys, come up with something. Come up with something good for your beard, your chin line, your crimson chin line. I just don't know. Anyway, let's start moving it down to see why I prefer it at this place. I might have been blocking the mic, by the way. So let's grab it. Now, first of all, let's just move it up once. You know, why don't I just move it up towards my mouth? Well, this is what the audio sounds like when I'm talking straight into it. Now, I'm purposefully talking a bit softer because I know this will very much clip the microphone and it might create a very bad sound. Now, I am gonna, you know, talk at my regular volume for 1 second. So, guys, get ready. Lower your volume if you have to. You ready? Okay, so guys, this is what I have been talking, you know, the entire time of this review, and it's probably very bad. So, apologies. Okay, so now it's back, you know, somewhere around my nipple line, and it should be a bit better. Now, I also quickly want to show off what it's like when you put it to the side. So, right now, it might still be in frame. I think it will still be in frame.
You will hear it's, you know, it's very soft. There's still some volume coming through, but it's way less. And the same applies when I'm holding it behind my head. That's, once again, there's no sound coming through because the sound is all going over there. And of course, yes, it's bouncing back. But even though it's bouncing back, I mean, my head is in the way. So it just can't get into the microphone properly. Now, like I mentioned, I also want to move it down and see what happens. So let's move it just one notch. Now, if it's here, it sounds pretty good, right? There's probably not a lot of difference with here. It might be a little bit less pronounced, a little bit less detailed because it's a bit further away from my mouth, but it should generally still be pretty good sound. This is at the nipple line, and this is still perfectly fine. Now, let's move it down, let's say towards about my belly button. Okay, so it doesn't really fit here for some reason. It's not my belly. My belly isn't that big. But it should be a bit less volume here. I think you guys can still hear me, but the audibility should be a lot lower. Now, one thing I also want to do is I kind of want to put it in my pocket because I've seen people put it in their pocket and still get proper sound. So, I mean, with different microphones. So let's put it in my pocket and let's just see what happens. So, let me just walk around a bit. You know, I'm talking in my pocket. I've got my hands around my pocket. I'm not quite sure what I'm saying, but you guys will be able to hear that the sound is just very abysmal. It's very bad. I can see it from the sound indicator. If the light stops blinding me, it doesn't really work that well. All right, so the microphone is back in its original place, and here it should be a lot better. Oh, wow, I just got a message from my smartwatch telling me that I've been doing a dynamic workout for the past 15 minutes. Do I really move around that much? Should I move around a bit less? Should I just do the cool guy pose? Should I be standing here like this? Okay, so one thing I do want to talk about is what exactly is on the receiver as well. The receiver is very simple. I'll put a video of it as well. And it's got a bar showing your decibel levels, showing you when you clip. So it's very nice. You can easily see from range, from, well, over here I can still very clearly see it because it's using different colors. And it just shows me that I'm talking reasonably loud, but nothing in, you know, the area where it would be too loud. So this is perfectly fine. Now, also there is a decibel level button, which switches between three different modes. There is the low, medium, and high mode, which just means that it bumps up the audio levels. I'm using the highest setting right now because I just find it to be the best because it's touching the high end, but it's not going over the high end. So it's great. Now, it's a very simple device. As you can see, it is also one with a battery life, both of these, of about 7 hours. Now, 7 hours should be plenty if you are doing a shoot on a film set for a day, or if you're doing YouTube like me. I mean, I've been doing this for about an hour now with all the fails and potential bloopers and stuff. So I'm very happy about it in general. Now, one thing that I do want to talk about very quickly before we end this review is the ability to connect it to devices. So what do I want to talk about this? Well, generally, let's say you have a camera, you can very easily just connect it to the camera through the cable that comes with it. Done. Simple. Provided your camera has a microphone input. In my situation, it was a little bit different because I wanted to connect it to my Huawei P10 Plus. And yes, I know I'm pronouncing it as Huawei. I know some people are saying like Huawei or something. I'm not quite sure what they say. And maybe that's the official pronunciation, but I'm going to go with Huawei. All right. Okay, so what I wanted to do, first of all, I was like, okay, what's the problem? Well, I thought the problem was that my phone didn't react to TRS, which is the type of 3.5 millimeter cable that comes with the microphone itself. And I would have to get a TRRS adapter, so TRS to TRRS. Well, I did that, and it still didn't work. So I spent like 3 or 4 days researching what the hell could this be. Well, in the end, it turned out that my aux port was just having issues and it works in other phones perfectly fine. So it was just me being an idiot. Yes, I did need the TRRS cable. That one was required because phones don't accept TRS because they see it as just a headphone input. But in my case, because my aux port was broken, I could either buy a new aux port, which costs like 70 euros, and I don't really want to do it myself because I'm crap at stuff like that. So I looked for other ways. Now, what I found is I can
transform the TRRS cable and put the signal into a 3.5 millimeter to USB-C adapter. So right now it's going into my USB-C port, the charging port for my phone, and it's working perfectly fine finally, so I can finally record this beautiful video that I just don't know what it's going to be like, because I feel like I've just been rambling for about an hour and now, my goodness. Okay, so I think I've talked about pretty much everything there is to talk about. I do want to quickly do a bit more rambling, but if you want to just, you know, hear the verdict from my end, this microphone is very good for its price. It costs you about 200 euros. I was contemplating getting the, I think it's Sennheiser XSWD, which is 350, which is also generally slightly higher quality from most people's perspectives. But it's like double the price, and I'm very happy with my purchase. I really like this one. I really want to use it a bit more. I'm actually very tempted to get like a proper camera. I kind of want to get like a Canon EOS M3 or M50 or something, you know, to get some proper quality. Anyway, moving back to the verdict, I very much recommend this, guys. It costs you 200. It's competitive with stuff double its price. Is it perfect? No. But is it very handy? Yes. It's very lightweight. It's just one of these things, one on your, you know, receiving device. You know, you might have to mess around with some cables, but that's okay, because I'm gonna make a separate video on that, and if I have it finished, I'll put a link in a comment down below just so you guys can see that. So if you want my recommendation, guys, go ahead and pick it up, because it's a beautiful device. Now, having talked about all of that, this part of the review is not going to be about the review. This part of the review is going to be about my experiences with this setup, because I've been enjoying it greatly, and this is more towards, you know, my subscribers and less towards people interested in buying the microphone. So like I mentioned, I've been messing around a lot with this setup, and I've been having a blast, by the way. I've literally got a table right now, and on top of the table I've got a tripod. On top of the tripod I've got my phone with, of course, you know, all of the stuff on the phone, and it's just working beautifully. It makes me want to buy a camera, like I mentioned. These cameras that I've been looking at come in between about 500 and 700 euros. It's a bit tricky, and don't really know whether I want to shelf that kind of money for YouTube. Well, YouTube is very much a hobby still. Of course, if I were to ever make money with it, it would be very easy to justify, but right now I just don't know whether I can justify it, even though I really want to buy it. So I've been having a blast recording this. It's been a lot of fun being in front of the microphone and in front of the camera specifically, because usually I'm sitting at my desk and, you know, I'm talking into a microphone, but I have way more freedom now. I can move my arms around and I just feel like I'm way more talkative. I feel like I have way more ways of expressing myself. I'm really enjoying also the acting part of it. So, you know, I move here and I come in here and I make a joke, and I kind of, you know, I feel like I'm talking to a person that's sitting across the table, and I feel like I'm talking to a friend who I'm explaining things to, instead of me talking into a microphone that's like literally pushed into my face because I can't see the microphone. So I've been rambling a lot, and honestly, the video might not be that great. I was tempted. I was like, I could do like a highly edited video. I can do a very structured video, like the PX, the headphone review that I did recently was very structured. I spent a lot of time editing it. I spent more time editing it than I spent recording it. I think I spent like 5+ hours editing that friggin' video down, and I loved every second of it. But I also really love this kind of video where I just stand in front of the microphone. Why do I keep saying microphone? Standing in front of the camera and just talk to you guys. So this is a very ranty video, and you know, it's probably not going to be the most viewed one because it's simply not really interesting to most people. But if you found this interesting, if you liked my style of presenting things, please do subscribe to the channel. Please do leave a comment down below. Tell me what you think of this, you know, this system I'm using right now, because I really want to do this a bit more. I bought this one for a purpose. I didn't buy it just for doing a singular review. That's just a nice commodity that came with the microphone. I bought it specifically so I could do a bit more reviews where I'm standing up, where I'm talking about the thing I'm reviewing, where I can hold it up, where I can use my arms to be a bit more expressive, where I just have the ability to crack some more jokes, because it's a lot easier to crack jokes when you're, you know, just standing and you can move your arms around. And I just really enjoyed it, and I really hope you guys enjoyed it as well. So this is both a review and a bit of a trial, I suppose. So if you liked this video, then please, like I mentioned, do subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below, tell me what you think. It's not about the subscribers to me in this situation, but you know, just let me know what you think, guys. I really care about your opinion. I really want to get better at this whole YouTube thing, because it's a beautiful thing, but it's so much work. Well, apparently my flash just stopped working, but I'm still recording. So I think my phone might be overheating or something. I'm not quite sure. So anyway, I think I'm going to be ending the video here. I might have been already cut off. So if I'm cut off, then I'm talking out of my ass for nothing. But like I mentioned, please let me know what you think, and tell me what kind of content you want to see. It's a bit of a channel update video as well as a review, I suppose. So thank you very much for watching for the 500th time. And have a nice day, guys. I will see you around. And now I'm gonna edit this shit down, and I'm gonna sit down because I'm sweating like an otter, and it's horrible.